Breaking developments in the race for 2016 tonight, 24 hours until our Republican debate, as I mentioned, right here on ABC, and the stakes could not be higher. The Republicans will square off for the last time before New Hampshire votes. Donald Trump, center stage, and on one side, Senator Ted Cruz, fresh off his win in Iowa. On the other side of Trump, Senator Marco Rubio, showing momentum in new polls. And the newest numbers coming in tonight as we come on the air, Trump holding on to his lead in New Hampshire, followed by Rubio with 17%, and Cruz and Ohio Governor John Kasich with 13%. ABC's Tom Yamas tonight on the all-out push at this hour, even in the middle of today's snowstorm in New Hampshire.
Donald Trump tonight snowed out of New Hampshire, sending voters this video from Trump Tower in Manhattan.
The great slogan of New Hampshire, live free or die, means so much to so many people. What a great slogan. Congratulations, New Hampshire. Wonderful job.
Today, Trump Force One grounded in New York. Trump's New Hampshire event empty. The seats unfilled. On Twitter, Jeb Bush snickering, tweeting at Trump, my 90-year-old mother made it out to campaign.
Vote for Jeb.
Oh, yeah.
And so she did. Former First Lady Barbara Bush at a New Hampshire diner, a Jeb sticker on her walker.
We need your vote.
Still, Trump tells me he's laser focused on winning here.
I'm only worried about one thing, and that's New Hampshire. We've got to win New Hampshire. I want to win New Hampshire. And then we go to South Carolina. But let's see how we do. So far, we're doing okay.
Today, his team of volunteers going door to door.
We just wanted to send out a reminder. Hand you a reminder and see if we could get your support for Mr. Trump on Tuesday.
And we're with them, trudging through the snow.
It's freezing. Is it worth it?
I think it's absolutely worth it.
We've got to take back our country, and we cannot let it continue to be in the wreck that it's in.
It's a nice day for campaigning.
But Trump's closest rival, Senator Ted Cruz, has a ground army of his own.
Hello.
Hello.
Good morning.
They're showing the type of dedication that helped Cruz win in Iowa.
He and I walking around out here are probably not going to change a lot of hearts and minds individually, but
you never know.
If it's one vote, it's worth it.
Especially worth it now that Cruz and Trump are feeling the heat from Senator Marco Rubio. As the Florida senator surges, his rivals on the attack.
He is simply not ready to be president of the United States.
His record of accomplishment is slim.
He's willing to break his word to the voters and make deals with Democrats.
We know who the boy in the bubble is up here.
But Rubio brushing it all off in an interview with our Jonathan Carl.
Are you ready for the onslaught?
Yeah, I think that's a good sign. I mean, it shows that our campaign is growing and that others are growing desperate. And that's fine. We'll be okay.
And Tom Yamas with us live tonight from a Cruz event. But you heard Marco Rubio there say that he's ready to brush off attacks, Tom. He's bracing for incoming fire given his new strength in the polls.
That's right, David, and we are waiting for Senator Ted Cruz to take the stage at any moment, but I just got off the phone with the Rubio campaign. They are expecting a lot of incoming at tomorrow night's debate, but they tell me Senator Rubio is going to stick to his message, which is that he gives the Republicans the best chance against the Democrats in November.